Hi everybody, I'm Joni Young, and today I want you to come away with me to Giverney France, one of Monet's water gardens. Get your paints ready and your brushes, and let's begin.
I've got phthalo blue, light ultramarine blue, neon purple violet, sap green, cadmium yellow, neon orange, phthalo green, dioxazine purple, and titanium white. I may be incorporating a few other colors along to this palette, and I'll list everything below in the description for you guys. So I'm gonna begin with the background. It's gonna be a light glowing green, yellowy green. Then we're gonna be building up a beautiful weeping willow tree way back there, the water, and then we'll do the bridge. It's gonna be covered in weeping wisteria, a beautiful purple lilac-y color. So for the background, I'm gonna take white and a little bit of yellow. So I've just got a little bit there and I'm just gonna let it blend on its own, and I'm going to start up and down. I'm going to take more of the yellow, a little bit of sap green this time. More white. So right in this area is going to be the brightest. This is where the main source of light is going to be coming from. So I'm going to use extra white paint right here. Take just a little bit of water on my brush. And sweep. A little bit more. Some white and some peach this time, along with the yellow. Right along in here. I'm just going to start tapping. Pull down, flick. Across. This is the water down here underneath the bridge. Now, if you don't have these specific colors that I'm using today, you can just use any variation that you have, any orange. And if you don't have any orange at all, you can use a light brown, a warm brown, like burnt sienna would work. So I'm going to take some more of this neon orange and white, mix the two together. You can see what a pretty color that makes. And I'm just gonna play up on that peachy color right here. This is gonna be really pretty with this light ultramarine blue. If you don't have that color, you can just take ultramarine blue or cobalt blue and mix it with white and you'll get the same thing. I'm gonna take some more yellow and white. Quite a bit of white, so it looks kind of like the color of butter. And I'm just gonna start tap in gently like this. This is going to create, see, you choose the right brush, you can just get instant weeping willow trees. That's all there is to it. Just tap side to side like this, straight up and down. And then I'm just gonna pull and flip down. All one flick. Some little streaks of light in the reflection of the water. And then pull. I have another light area right here. And then it's just gonna get a little bit shorter. I always like to go both directions. That gives it more of that water look. Reflective. Got a little bit up in there. A little bit here. Okay, I'm going to come in with some green now. Now what I can do, instead of taking the time to squeeze out some turquoise, I can just take my phthalo green like this. A little bit of white. I'm going to use both of these green, sap green, little bit of yellow. I'm not blending too much on my brush because I want multi-tones happening randomly and organically for this tree. See all those different colors you get all at once? This is how you save yourself some time, you guys. Right down here. We're gonna cut in with a really dark, dramatic shadow in here after. And then you can just lightly, barely touching that canvas, pull and flick. Gives you that really soft, blurry look. I'm gonna take more of my sap green now. I'm gonna switch over to my right hand. Hopefully that's not gonna get in the way too much of filling. It comes right down here. All this tapping is making my easel go a little nuts, so sorry for all of the noise. So we're gradually coming in with this, almost like a little vignette, drawing us into this beautiful area right here. There's going to be some, they're a little bit. Now I'm going to get my brush wet, really, really wet, and here we go, guys. I'm going to do my drips. Push, pull, and let off. Let's come in from this side, do the same thing. A little bit more water, wiggle to loosen that paint up. And I've got an old concrete floor underneath, so I don't care. It could drip away onto the floor, but you might want to be mindful of what's underneath on your floor before you do this. I'm just going to dry the excess off and go back for some sap green. I'm actually going to take a little bit of my dioxazine purple. I like to mix sap with my dark purple for a nice deep dark color that's not just black, because that can be, black is kind of boring. Okay, a little bit like that. I'm gonna slide my brush. I picked up a little bit of that phthalo green, which is totally fine. Okay. Just laying out where my shadows are. The area like that. Slight little flick. In there. Pull. Switch over to my other hand. Sometimes I just paint with both hands, usually just my left hand, but working on a large canvas like this, my arms can get kind of tired, and with the filming purposes, it's kind of easier for me to just switch to this hand and try to reach over and cover the canvas, and then you guys won't see what I'm doing. Add a little bit more shadow here, color. Okay, down right on the top here. It's going to be darker. I'm going to play up on some purple in here. Let's begin taking just a little bit of white and just tinting our dioxazine. Got a kind of a dirty purple mauve color here. Let's just start tapping, very lightly wiggling, just to create an interesting color over here, I think. That's kind of neat. And then we can take that color and start pulling both ways. You can turn your brush like this, you can turn it like this, and maybe right down here on the bottom. And I'm going to take my Filbert brush. Now, because I want this part to be really, really dark, I'm going to blend it again with my purple. Deep, dark dioxazine purple. Blend the two slightly. Get a lot on the tip of your brush. And right in this area, I'm going to tap. Start tapping it lightly up into this wet paint. Add some more. In from the other side. So our bridge is going to start from this point and it's going to get over to this point right here. So just keep that in mind. Make sure it's quite even. And I'm going to take another large blending brush. It's completely dry. Painting wet on wet. My paint is drying slowly because I've got my studio at a really, well, I've got no heat on right in here right now. So I've got my cadmium yellow medium hue. Just a little bit. It's very strong. You're using good quality paint. You only need just a little bit because it's highly concentrated. So this brush is a little bit fuzzy on the bottom, which is going to make for some nice foliage in here. Actually, and just start tapping a little bit more yellow in this area. Enjoying working on a black canvas lately. I love the dramatic mood. It really does add a mood to your paintings. So right here, right there next to that little line where the bridge is going to start, just want to do something like that. Main light right in there. I'm like a little bit fuzzy and foggy in here. I know you guys love this one, and with all your guys' links and tips and comments on thinking you found it, I have checked them all. Every one of them that you guys have mentioned, I've checked them all and I cannot find this brush. I think they must have discontinued it, and I'm really glad that I got this one. I did, because it is my magic brush. I love it. Little bit of my yellow, tap it into that dirty purpley green color that I have there just to tone it a little bit, and I'm just going to see if I can create another color in here. It is. Pop it around here. So not a lot. Let's just dry brush that out. The leftover paint in the brush, dry brush it out in the water. Our phthalo sap green, a little bit of white. And you can tap some of that in here. Tap. And then I'm going to use a little bit of water to make this look kind of wiggly. And how about some phthalo and cadmium yellow? Let's add a little bush right here. See, this brush just makes the perfect little bushes. Just love it. A little bit more yellow on that one. And then a little bit of white. Because we know this is going to dry a little bit darker. Some low-lying bushes right in here. I'm going to leave this area dark. Some more of our green. Take a little bit of my light ultramarine blue in my blending brush again. Now you can just see as I hold this color up with the green and the yellow in the background how pretty those colors look together, and with this peach. So I'm going to start tapping. Quick taps. I'm going to start to work the paint out of my brush. Switch over. Add some in here. Pick a little bit more up. And I'm going to start laying in some lines or a shadow. The bridge is casting this shape down here. And you don't have to get this exact. Okay, just a little something like that. I'm gonna tap and kind of swish around with my finger. I want this to look like it's foggy and misty. Take some of my neon purple violet, phthalo blue. Tap the two together on here, along with my light ultramarine blue. I'm going to add darker shade right there. Sort of an arch like that. And then come down right here. Pull from the side. Beautiful, beautiful color. So I'm really exaggerating the reference photos that I've been looking at and doing this my own thing that I always encourage you guys to do. I'm just going to tap in here, make some purpley bushes in here. I want to use these colors for my shadows because they're just so complementary. And we can just tie a little bit in there as well. A little bit more. Hold in. Maybe there's some little water lilies in here. I'm sure there would be, being Monet's garden. He's famous for his water lilies. And I'm gonna go over to a little mop brush. Take a little bit of my light ultramarine blue. Take a bit of that neon purple violet. Just get a lighter shade here. And have some low-lying little bushes here. Just a little bit like that. Soften that up. And I want to make this a little blurry and wiggly. So just kind of loosen that paint up a little bit. All these pretty pastel colors. I'm just going to take a little bit of white with my light ultramarine blue. Wipe the excess off on a towel and barely touching the canvas, light little pulls, wiggles, and flicks. A little bit in here. Okay, so I just decided to get a little bit of neon pink. I'm going to use a little bit of my yellow. Tap those colors together and we'll begin incorporating some beautiful pink tones in here. Corally peachy pink color. Where that beautiful golden light is, you can add some right down in here. That light at the end of the day, just casting on some pretty plants and flowers back here. I'm gonna take my neon purple violet with a little bit of neon pink like this, and just a little indication of some color back there. I'm gonna switch over to my tiny little mop brush, and I'm gonna take some sap green with that neon purple violet. And I'm almost tapping over the top of it, but not quite. I'm just gonna leave a little bit of that there. Stumbling in. Soft little circles. Add some more sap green. I want this to be just a little bit more shadow down in here. Now this is an interesting brush that I haven't really used very much. It's size number 50. It's like a really large Filbert brush. I don't really know. I haven't used it very much, so I think I just want to try using that right now. More dioxazine purple. Maybe a little bit of phthalo blue. Let's make our own rich, deep color. You just want to get the whole end like that, and let's start very lightly. Bring another little shadow in here. pulling and flicking. Slight little pull and flick down here for a little bit of a reflection of that in the water. Let's add some more shadow in here. So nice, it kind of just frames it all in like this. Okay, I'm just gonna do a sweet little tap in here. We'll pick a few spots like this where it's gonna be a little bit darker. The more of this you add, the more mood you're going to create. I'll switch over to my number 11 flat brush. I need this for the nice flat straight end that it has. Get it a little bit wet first. I'm going to take some white along with that light ultramarine blue. Slightly blend, pull, so you get a little line like that. I'm just going to do little dabs. Wiggling and tapping, making light little pockets. Almost all the way over. Do tight little wiggles side to side without taking your brush off. Don't think about it too much. The quicker you are and the less you think about it, the better it'll look and the easier it'll be. And look at how instantly that looks like. Blurry, reflective water. A little bit of movement. Okay, you can do as many of those as you want. Have fun with your painting. Don't get intimidated or overwhelmed with what you see me doing. Let this just inspire you and invoke what you want to create, your inner artist. Wiggle, wiggle, and then pull side to side. Picking up some more light for this area to make it brighter. I'm actually gonna take a little bit of phthalo green. Now I accidentally took too much. I forgot a little goes a really long way. So I'm just gonna tint my white to make it that kind of a minty color like this. Push and pull, have it on the tip of my brush. And I'm just gonna do a light little mist of that, make it look misty. Push, pull, and flick. Get a little bit of water on my brush so that it doesn't look so patchy. Sometimes you want to have those little patches of canvas showing through for a certain look, and then other times you just really don't. Pull in my light ultramarine blue here. just grabbed what's left in my tube. I'm just about out of it. And I'm gonna turn my brush this way, put my hand over the top. Barely touch that canvas. A little bit of that back there. I'm gonna just tap on the edge a little bit so that doesn't look so straight. Because we've got some bushes in here coming over the edge. I'm gonna begin the bridge now, and I'm gonna do this very just loosely. I'm not, you know, drawing it out. I'm not planning it too much. And I'm gonna take purple and sap green first. On the tip of my brush. So right from here, well, let's go from about here. You just want to be brave. Leave space. And then I'm going to come right from here, right from about here, pull up, and then have it blend in. Few of these up and over. I'm just going to take my mini fan brush and I'm going to add a little bit of foliage right under here, where I brought the bridge down a little bit into that dark area and it's getting kind of lost. So let's just take some white and sap green. A little bit on an angle like this. Okay, just by doing this, makes this look a little bit better over here. Kind of hides any imperfection that you might have on that side. I'm going to take my number two angular brush, and pick up a little bit more of my phthalo green, mix it with some white. His famous bridges in his water garden are this beautiful turquoise color. Make it just a little bit darker. Mix and then get enough on your brush to work with. So it's a little bit more in shadow down here. Comes a little bit wider right there. Start to come down here. I'm gonna take my light green, just do a few little flowers in there, straighten that out. I want to add a little bit of my light green down in here, a little bit more just to make this part of the bridge stand out. I'm just gonna go over this really lightly, just so that it's darker than this color. Marine blue and white. fill this in. Just a little bit of a glow and pop of color like that. Can bring a little bit more light in here now. A little bit more of our purple. Light ultramarine blue. Slide your brush. I'm going to take a little bit of white, yellow, and pink. I'm going to add little hints of it in here. It's okay, I just picked up a little bit of that phthalo green. Let's take a little bit of my sack green. There's some lines that go up here, some bars for the top of this bridge. And I'm just gonna use my dark colors to come high up here. Just using my darkest color. You can barely see that one because it's in shadow. The one there. And then we'll put one right here. Another one. Right about here. Very lightly. Right down there. And then we're going to go up and over. And you'll do a few of those. Up and over. Like you're painting a rainbow. Now I'm going to switch over to my large flat brush just because the size of canvas, it'll be a lot easier. So I'm going to do 4 of these lines. And because it goes way up there, you're not going to see those. They go past the canvas, so you just see them down here. We'll just add a little one right there. I'm just going to add my turquoise inside of here, brighten this up a little bit. A little bit more light showing here. We're going to come up, over, try to do it all in one stroke. I'm going to pick up a little bit more of the phthalo and make this slightly darker here. Okay, and then there's going to be another one that comes in here and it joins in with that one. Of the angle. And one more. And these all join in together. Are you guys feeling brave? Take a little bit more of my very little green. And then a little bit of white to cut in there with a highlight. Now we're going to do our hosts. I'm going to attach this railing together so that same color. So we've got this one here. And then there's the little line that comes down there. Comes off to the side like this. And then there's one in the background on the other side. Okay, and then that line goes like that. So just do these one at a time with me, guys. And a shadow of dark phthalo. And then we've got another one that comes here in the foreground. And that line again. Make that one a little bit thicker. And one behind. Back there, and so on and so forth. So even though your bridge has that bow to it, you want to keep your railing, these little posts, straight. Straight up and down. Okay, I'm going to take a little bit of phthalo blue. Phthalo blue and white. And add just a little bit of phthalo blue to this post here, and maybe a little bit hint of color up here, a little bit, maybe some right up here. Maybe we can have some little bushes back in here, make it a little bit darker. Just by taking some yellow, purple, and sap green, you can just tap like that. And then, so I'm not crazy about my little posts on the bridge, they might not look even. So this is kind of a good way to camouflage those. Start coming in with some purple. I'm going to take purple phthalo and white, still just using my flat brush, and I'm going to start this beautiful wisteria. And then no white, just phthalo and purple as it gets over here. So see how I'm just kind of pushing, tapping around with my brush. Right up there. I'm going to take a small number 8 Filbert brush, take some white, make a little bit of a lighter shade now, and just add some little highlights. Imagine they're just cascading and just falling down this beautiful arbor above this bridge. Take a big scoop of phthalo and dioxazine purple. And I'm just gonna roughly add some wiggles here for some branches. And I'm doing this purple and blue because I thought it would be nice to break up all that green. You could use a liner brush for this too if you want. Squeeze a little bit. My turquoise in here. I'm just going to break this up a little bit. I'm going to take my longest liner brush that I have and just pull in some little bits of grass in here. So I'm going to use my sap green and purple. A little reflection in the water. I go back to my angle brush with light turquoise. Light it up like that, come down. And just carefully add some highlights on top of some parts of the railings. And then add some shadow. So I'm going to continue to add some little vines and branches using those same colors, the phthalo blue. And the purple. Let's add some more pretty reflections in the water. I'm nearing the end of my paintings. I like to go back and just add little bits of color. Should tie in some turquoise in here too. Turquoise and phthalo. Sap green in there too. Let's just have a whole bunch of that beautiful wisteria right in this area, just hanging down. How gorgeous. You guys like to be on this bridge right now? I know I would. I hope you guys are really enjoying this painting today, and it's kind of made you get out of your everyday life, got you inspired, try something new. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate each and every one of you and all your support that you give me on my channel. Stay happy and healthy, stay positive, guys, and I'll see you next time in a brand new video. Bye!